It's possible to create complex instruments and music without ever touching the Keyzone section of the sampler. However, if you want to control how different samples are played across a range of notes and velocities, then that instrument will need to make use of Keyzones. When you load a sample, by default, its Keyzone occupies all possible notes and velocities, with their respective pitch and volume responding as you'd expect. Load other samples into the same instrument, and they also have their own separate full Keyzone, so they all play at the same time. These behaviours, along with many other things, can be changed by the user. Before we get into how the interface works, let's take a look at the Keyzone presets. Each section of the sampler has its own preset type that can be loaded and saved using the drop-down menu located at the top right corner of the sampler. The Keyzone section is the most interesting, however, since the instrument samples are kept in their own directory and the Keyzone information is stored in the open source format of SFZ. So, exporting from here allows the samples and Keyzones created in Renoise or Redux to be imported into other software and hardware that can use SFZ files. And likewise, SFZ files from external sources can be imported. And since the older and very popular sound font format of SF2 can be easily converted into SFZ, you have a huge resource of audio files that can be imported into Renoise or Redux via this menu. Anyway, let's get back to how to use the Keyzones. The interface consists of this large central grid that displays the Keyzones, with various options above and below, and we'll get to those in a bit. The grid's note range of C0 to B9 is represented horizontally, while the velocity range of 00 to 80 is shown vertically. When a key is pressed, either with the computer keyboard or via a MIDI controller, its note and velocity values are translated into a coordinate on the Keyzone grid. If this coordinate is within a Keyzone's range, then it will be activated and its sample is usually played. The overlap mode can change this, and again, we'll get to that later. However, if the coordinate falls in empty space, then nothing happens. To zoom in and out on the grid like this, just use the mouse wheel, and the scroll bar underneath can be used to move around while zoomed in. A Keyzone can be selected by left-clicking on it, or by selecting a sample from the sample list. This becomes the active Keyzone, with a highlighted colour and small squares on all four sides. The active zone's range is displayed in the note and velocity value boxes underneath the grid. You can resize the range of an active zone by changing these values or by click-dragging one of its edges. Click-dragging inside the zone will move it around. If you hold down left shift and left click on another zone, both this and the active zone are selected, along with any zones between them on the grid. You can also left click anywhere except the active zone and drag to select a range of zones. Holding left control or command on the Mac and left clicking on zones will select or deselect them, allowing you to pick any combination from the grid. When multiple zones are selected, any changes made to the active zone will also affect the others. And by the way, if you find that your selected key zone changes when playing notes, it's because the auto select option in the sample list is enabled, which allows key zones to be automatically selected by notes that are played within their range. To create a new key zone, you can either load a sample, insert a new sample via the sample list, or right-click on the grid to open the context menu and choose Insert New Load Samples. Alternatively, select one or more samples from the disk browser, then drag them onto the Keyzone grid to place them where you want. And notice that the horizontal size can be adjusted by moving the mouse pointer up and down before letting go of the mouse button. A keyzone can be deleted by selecting it and pressing Delete, or using the right-click menu and selecting Remove. But remember that this will delete the sample as well. At the top left of the interface are two buttons that switch between creating keyzones for Note On, Key Press, and Note Off, Key Release events. To move a sample's keyzone to the Note Off layer, right-click on the zone, or its name in the sample list, and select Move to Note Off layer. And use the same method to move zones back to the Note On layer. Note Offs are a commonly used feature that can trigger a few changes to an instrument. See the Note Off and NNA video for more details. Using Note Off samples and keyzones, however, can be a little tricky, but potentially very powerful when linked to other features. So see the separate sampler Note Off layer video if you're interested. The way that the keyzones work in the Note Off layer is identical to what's already been demonstrated, but notice that the options at the top right are disabled here, since they only apply to samples in the Note On layer. So, let's check those out next. The Drum Kit button can be used with anything, but will most commonly be used for drums, since it assigns each sample to a keyzone that's a single note wide, starting from the note selected in this value box. Clicking here will open a drop-down menu with two additional options. Use White Keys Only will only assign zones to the white keys, while First Octave for transposing will assign an entire octave to the first sample of the instrument. The Distribute button evenly distributes all key zones horizontally across the grid, while Layer will reset them back to the default of spanning the full note and velocity range. Now let's look at the keyzone options on the bottom, where you've already seen the note and velocity value boxes. The bass note represents the sample's original pitch, so changing this will transpose the sample relative to the note played. The current bass note is shown by this block at the top and bottom of the grid, and you can also change it by clicking here. The Key Pitch button controls whether things run normally by changing a sample's pitch depending on the key pressed, or, when disabled, always playing at the pitch of the bass note. And likewise, the Vel/Vol button ties the sample volume to the note velocity, or, when disabled, always playing at full volume. Disabling these options can be useful when creating more complex instruments with a lot of keyzones, since you can maintain pitch and or volume while still making use of different values to alter the sound. The overlap setting dictates how samples will be played when their key zones overlap, and more than one is triggered at the same time. The default option, Play All, will just play all the samples all the time. Cycle will play each sample one at a time in the order of the sample list. And, as you'd expect, Random will randomly play one of the samples. With a sliced sample, your options are far more limited. The Note Off layer is unavailable. Zones cannot be adjusted by velocity, and, aside from the initial sample, can only be a single note in width. However, the key pitch, vel/vol, and drum kit options are still available. You can regain control of the other options, and the key zones in general, by choosing to destructively render slices.